आई एम डॉक्टर जेसी जॉन, असिस्टेंट प्रोफेसर, डिपार्टमेंट ऑफ एनाटॉमी, ज्योति विद्यापीठ, वुमेन्स यूनिवर्सिटी, जयपुर. सो टुडे वी विल डिस्कस द सम पार्ट्स ऑफ द एनाटॉमी ऑफ बिलियरी एपरेटस. दीस आर वी विल डिस्कस सिस्टिक डक्ट एंड कॉमन बाइल डक्ट एंड द स्ट्रक्चर्स ऑफ ऑल दीस थिंग्स. So today we will continue from the cystic duct. Cystic duct is about 3 to 5 centimeter long and runs backward and downward from the neck of the gallbladder to run in the lesser omentum with common hepatic duct and joins it at acute angle to form the bile duct. The junction with common hepatic duct is usually situated immediately below the porta hepatis, and mucous membrane lining the interior of the cystic duct is shown into a series of crescentic folds that are 5 to 10 in number. They project into the lumen in a spiral fashion, forming a spiral fold that is called spiral valve. The valve of the Hester keeps the duct open so that bile can pass through it both in and out of the gallbladder. When the common bile duct is closed at its inferior end, the bile secreted by the liver fills the duct and passes through the cystic duct into the gallbladder. When the common bile duct is open, the bile flows into it from the common bile, common hepatic and cystic ducts. The flow of the bile is augmented by the contraction of the gallbladder. It is coordinated by the relaxation of the sphincter of the common bile duct under the influence of the cholecystokinin, a hormone that is released by the duodenal mucosa. And we can see here, this is the right and left hepatic duct, and this is and this is common hepatic duct, and this is the cystic duct that form the common bile duct, and this is the angulation. Here they form the angle between the cystic duct and common hepatic duct. Now we will discuss about the common bile duct, that is we say bile duct also. This is formed by the union of the cystic and common hepatic duct, and it is usually 7.5 centimeter long and about 6 millimeter in diameter. It is divided into two parts: supraduodenal part, retroduodenal part, and infraduodenal part and intraduodenal part. Supraduodenal part is about 2.5 centimeter long and descends in the right free margin of the lesser omentum to the right of the hepatic artery proper and anterior to the portal vein. Retroduodenal part, it descends behind the first part of the duodenum with the gastroduodenal artery on its left and inferior vena cava on its posterior aspect. Infraduodenal part means pancreatic part. It runs in the grooves on the upper and lateral parts of the posterior surface of the pancreas and sometimes completely embedded in the pancreatic tissue. Here it lies in front of the inferior vena cava, from which it is separated by a thin layer of pancreatic tissue. It is accompanied on the left side by gastroduodenal artery, which gives origin to the superior pancreaticoduodenal artery. The superior pancreaticoduodenal artery crosses the bile duct either anteriorly or posteriorly. Clinically, it is a source of hemorrhage in the exposure of infraduodenal part of the bile duct. Near the middle second part of the duodenum, it comes in contact with the pancreatic duct. Now, intraduodenal part, it enters the posteromedial surface of the descending part of the duodenum. A little below to its middle, the main pancreatic duct also enters the wall of the duodenum at the same site. The two ducts run obliquely in the wall of the duodenum and unite to form an expansion, the hepatopancreatic ampulla, which bulges the mucous membrane of the duodenum inward, forming the major duodenal papilla. The distal constricted end of this ampulla opens on the summit of the major duodenal papilla, 8 to 10 centimeter distal the phalloris. Now we will discuss sphincters, that is the most important part of this topic, around the terminal part of the bile and pancreatic ducts and ampullae. The intramural parts, it means terminal parts of the bile and pancreatic ducts, as well as ampulla, are surrounded by smooth muscle sphincter. This sphincter around the bile duct called sphincter cholecystocytes, and sphincter around the pancreatic duct is called sphincter pancreaticus. And the sphincter around the ampulla is called sphincter ampullae and the sphincter of Oddi. The three sphincters are independent of duodenal musculature. The sphincters remain closed until the gastric contents enter the duodenum, stimulating its mucosa to release a hormone called cholecystokinin. This hormone, in addition to causing contraction of the gallbladder, relaxes these sphincters, allowing bile and pancreatic secretion enter the duodenum. So this sphincter facilitate the enter the bile into the duodenum. Arterial supply of the bile duct or the common bile duct. Upper part of the bile duct is supplied by a twig from the descending branch of the cystic artery, while its lower part is supplied by the ascending branch of the superior pancreatico duodenal artery. Superior pancreatico duodenal artery. And now this is the assignments, and these are two questions that describe the common bile duct and describe the gallbladder with its spots and what is the cystic duct. So you should do all these things in your notebook, and if you have any query, please let me know. I will resolve very soon. Thank you so much.